Honorable Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh State, Dr. Raman Singh, dignitaries on the dais and dear friends. We had a very great start today morning with a very inspiring speech from Honorable Chief Minister and other dignitaries. And this is followed by yesterday's wonderful full day, which demonstrated high degree of engagement from all the participants, high degree of energy, and charting the course for Make in India vision to reality. Good support from the media. We see a lot of coverage in both print and online media today, and everything is rocking on electronics, not only inside this room, but also outside in all the media things. Thank you very much for that. As we go along the day, I would like to remind you, yesterday in my inaugural speech, I did indicate that ISA is working towards accelerating the roadmap for the ESDM industry, and we're working on four pillars. And I will share with you the roadmaps and the report card for those. So yesterday we covered two pillars already. One was on the MCEPs and the EMC, electronic manufacturing cluster. You already got the update and the roadmap. And number two, on the startup ecosystem. And today, in short, I will share with you two more initiatives we are working on, and what is that we are going to do about it. The first and foremost, we see that we need to really expand our semiconductor and ATMP footprint in the country. However, we realized that there is neither a trained manpower available for that, nor there is an ecosystem, nor there is a vendor base. And then that is where we need to depend on some international collaborations. And I was talking to one of my colleague, SSI president, Singapore Semiconductor Industry Association. I realized there are 12 wafer fabs in a country of Singapore and 20 ATMPs and allied ecosystem. And somebody asked me in a meeting, how does India look like? And what can I say? You know, after listening to four states, you can imagine it's so diverse. We thought it's really good idea to really create one white paper, a short summary report, which can capture what are the ESDM opportunities within India and what Singapore is doing, and then create a clear focus, sharpen and harness that content so that the industries and governments from both the countries, they can look at that and then define the collaborative steps, how we go forward. So with that, we came out with this conclusion and the report, which will be released today. And I would request later on the Honorable Chief Minister to do the honors to release the report. We'll also share with you a summary of that report, which shows incredible potential that exists in the bilateral cooperation and collaborations and business dealings, trade agreements between Singapore and India, particularly for ESDM sector. And there is a possibility of almost like 18% CAGR over next decade. The second important initiative is related to talent, but before that I want to request you to dwell upon one point. Many times when we discuss in all our forums, we said that we need a strong government and industry cooperation and a collaboration. Yesterday we had a government panel discussion, five states, and today we have the four states here, including two chief ministers and honorable chief minister of Chhattisgarh state. 25 high-level officers from the states are with us today actually in this event. What is this? This is a strong example of the government and industry collaboration. Please give a round of applause to all of our states. Those are really spending time with the industry. And it is not a question of competition. It is more of a commitment from their side. It is commitment from their side to the industry. Please come. We want to help you. We want to support you. Flourish the industry. Help the economic development of the country. And that is where now the ball comes back in the court of the industry. They have done their bit. It's for industry now to really come forward, step forward, and begin their harnessing of their business plans, looking at that $400 billion story, and start putting those investments and activities so that we really accelerate the speed at which we need to grow and reduce that import dependence of the electronics. The second point which I wanted to update you today is about the talent. And we always keep talking about the talent, despite of having so much of a manpower, 15 million engineers being coming out every year, and many people working already into the respective domains. However, as this industry grows, we also forecasted that there would be need of 2.7 crore additional jobs, those would be created. And not only the fundamental knowledge, which is important, but also the skills those are required so that the people become industry ready. And for that, there is a strong need of taking some additional activities and initiatives. So today we are going to roll out on behalf of ISA a a roadmap and a program which will ignite the industry and academia cooperation and scale up, speed up the activities which we have been doing. Some of you have been already engaged in our activity called the Talent CIG. We have been doing this work now for the last more than 2 years. We have done the experiments, we have done the field trials and the testing, and we are now ready to go for scaling up of that. And today we will sign 3 MOUs to scale up these activities so that as one side we create the industry demand which is increasing, another side we create the industry investment so that the industry can develop, but also we create the manpower and the resource base so that we can speed up all these implementations in a much faster way. We'll sign the MOUs today with Visveshwarya Technological University. We'll sign the MOU today with Electronic Sector Skill Council of India, with KEBITS, and also with RVBLSI. So time is really running fast, and also we need to run fast. So based on yesterday's roadmaps and today's discussions with states, engagements, and the industry participants, I think time has come now for us to really keep running fast and fast and fast so that we execute our programs and plans within time, and also accelerate our journey towards making India ESDM powerhouse. With that, I would complete my speech and we continue with the next phase of the program. Thank you.